So, welcome back. It's finally time again to do a shoe review. This time it's about the new, or not that new anymore, the Nike Zoom Fly 4. I've been testing it over the past few months, actually. Unfortunately, didn't have the time to run that much in them because I'm currently in my competition phase. And yeah, that's something which we are going to talk about with the shoe. It's not really a shoe I'm using during my competition period. It is my first Zoom Fly, so I didn't use the editions before. But yeah, it is very specific to me, and it's not as good of an all-rounder which I thought it would be. It's a great threshold shoe, but as I have all these carbon plated shoes, I have a tendency to run my thresholds in them. You could use it very well for thresholds, so if you don't want to waste your carbon plated racers, like a Vaporfly or a Takumi, or I don't know, there are many out there, you can for sure use the Zoom Fly 4. But what I found is the cushioning is way more stiff. It's not as bouncy as from, for example, from the Vaporfly or from the Alphafly. So that's something which is, I wouldn't say it bothers me, but I feel way more comfortable in the Vaporflies. And I feel like the recovery aspect in those shoes is way better than it is in these shoes. Here, I feel like you have a much bigger drop, so you get pushed more to your tiptoes than you would be in a traditional Vaporfly, and that's something I felt quite immediately. But still, the shoe is very, very responsive. I would say even more than the Vaporflies, and that's possibly because of the drop and that they are more rigid and not as soft as the Vaporflies. So all in all, I would say it's a great shoe for fartleks or even threshold sessions. It's better on the track than I was expecting it to be, as the upper is a little bit thicker. And yeah, I mean, the upper is really the strong part of the shoe, because you have really like a sock sensation, which is really great. It really, your foot sits really nice in them, and you get hugged by this by the upper material, so it feels almost like a sock, which is really nice. At the beginning, you feel like you might slip out of them, like it would be a sock, but I never had the experience during a run. Actually, it's just the first impression when you get into the shoe, but while wearing it, no issues at all. And then on the durability point, that's what I was a little bit worried about, or I wanted to try longer so that I can say something about it, because I feel like the Vaporflies or the Alphaflies, the durability is not that great. Well, you don't expect it to be great, but from a shoe like this, you expect it to be a little bit better, and it is. I've put, let's say, 200 kilometers now around in them, and you can basically see nothing at all. So the shoe has a way better durability than the Vaporflies or the Alphaflies, which you would expect from a quality training shoe. I wouldn't call it a daily trainer, for sure not. Even if the Ingebrigtsens, for instance, you see them warming up before meet and them, so you could use them as a daily trainer, I guess. But I don't like that there's this carbon plate which makes them quite stiff. I like my easy run days shoes, that they are a little bit more flexible, so that my feet are actually working a little bit more natural, and I keep the carbon and the firmer shoes for harder and faster sessions. So yeah, what could you use this shoe for? I use it currently for fartlek days, where I do like kind of on and off, so 1k a little bit faster, 1k a little bit slower, but not on threshold, but just to get some quality into a run. That's something I use it a lot. Then probably a Sunday long run, where you want to finish a little bit more progressive and you want to feel a little faster at the end. And then something I start to use it is for hills. I used to wear the Zoom Streakfly for hills, but yeah, I tend to do longer hill sessions and I feel like the protection there is not that great, and I feel like I recover a little bit better in those because of the high cushioning still. And the Zoomfly is really reactive, but it has a smaller sole, so the cushioning is not that great. And therefore, I tend to use these now for hills and longer sub-threshold efforts. If you have any questions about the shoe, which I kind of like, feel free to drop them in the comments. And as usual, you get them at top4running.com. And with my code BOBRUN, you get 5% off. They're even currently on sale. So choose one of the many colors they have there and get your hands on them. And yeah, again, if you have any questions, feel free to ask.